guys, Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. Today we're going to talk about something that guitar players can get hung up on doing sometimes for years before they eventually stop doing it and move on to something else that works a lot better. And what I'm talking about is how many guitar players will only use one scale, usually the pentatonic scale, to play over all the chords in a riff that they're jamming on. And this tends to happen whether a guitarist is involved with composing a worked out melody or if it's a guitarist improvising a guitar solo. Now, the root cause of this problem is unfortunately a little deeper than just being locked into playing one scale over a riff, because the problem also involves not including two of the coolest sounds that are possible when it comes to playing over any group of chords, and those are the use of modes and arpeggios, in particular arpeggios. So let's get started by establishing a rhythm guitar backing track. We'll analyze the key signature and then we'll learn how to spice it up. Now, in a general sense, a guitar player will typically rely on their most comfortable approach when it comes to playing melody and soloing. And for most guitar players, that melodic connection to the chords will come from the notes of pentatonic scale. So let's get things started by learning a chord riff. We'll use it to demonstrate why pentatonic is typically used so often and, you know, maybe a little bit too much. And we'll play through everything. I'll teach it to you. And then from that example, we're going to take things a lot further in the next half of this lesson, because we're going to dig into how you can improve those sounds through arpeggios and through the use of a mode. Let's get things started with a quick playthrough of this rhythm guitar part that I have for you. It goes like this. Alright, so you can tell probably it's in E minor, and you can hear it right away how the E minor chord is the real focal point. We're dealing with a lot of triads with this progression based between 4th string and 2nd string. The first triad is frets 5-4-5, then we move up into a C, which is a bar at 5th fret, and then we've got a 5th fret A major chord across 7, 6, and 5. We also have two note chords that are coming off of the 7th and 8th frets and 7th fret barred on 3rd and 2nd strings. After that, we come back to that E minor triad at 5-4-5, head down to a G triad at 5-4-3, and then we do a really nice A major that's inverted with the C sharp in the bass. That's the 4th fret on the 5th string, C sharp. At the end, we do have a 2nd and 3rd fret two note chord coming into a bar at the 2 2nd frets, again on the 3rd and 2nd strings. Now, I have this progression in the loop pedal, and what I want to do next is I'm going to hit the looper. We're going to get this playing back, and if you're a Patreon member, you're going to get this loop as a download that you can work with at home. So I hope to see you next on the Patreon for this part 2 video of this lesson, and of course for the download that you're going to get there. But let's take a look at what's happening with this pentatonic melody. So here's those chord changes I was telling you about. They're in the loop and behind, and what we're going to do next is use some E minor pentatonic scale and play a melody. Well, as you can hear, pentatonic sounds pretty good. It's a decent sound, but we can do better, and we're going to take a short break. When we come back, we're going to check out some arpeggio work that we can do with this, and we're also going to check out some Dorian mode. Coming up next, I'm going to show you how to stop being so dependent on the pentatonic scale and how you can instead start using arpeggios and a mode called Dorian. But first, I want to tell you about a promotional offer that I'm running from my new Handouts Collection ebook, Volume 7. My handout collection ebook, Volume 7, is now available. This is a collection of study material I've been organizing for over 2 years. It has 100 pages of excellent guitar instruction, and if you're one of the thousands of guitar players who've received an earlier edition, you already know how much there is to learn from this book. Handout Collection Volume 7 is a 100-page PDF ebook that you can download to use at home. You'll get a link to the file within 24 hours of making a donation of $5 or more to the website. Now, Volume 7 covers dozens of chords, arpeggio workouts, harmonized key exercises, triad studies, scale practice drills, all the popular modes, plus jazz theory, and a new section on melodic playing, along with pretty much every type of guitar notation worksheet paper. The Handout Collection 7 ebook is available with any donation over $5 made to the Creative Guitar Studio website. Just visit creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to help lend support and download yourself one amazing guitar book. The pentatonic scale might sound decent, but there are better methods for covering most of the chord changes used in music, and two of these important ideas are ones that can take us a lot further into using more sophisticated sounds, more sophisticated notes that make up the chords that are being played in our backing tracks. Now, two unique ways that you can use to do this are going to be by applying arpeggios and also modes. Now, for our example, I'm going to show you how to cover chords using the minor 7 arpeggio and the Dorian mode. The first thing that we're going to do is look at some minor 7 arpeggio concepts on the neck. The first layout of this that we're going to do, because it's a rather large layout that I want to cover, the first layout is going to go a little more to the guitar's headstock here. The layout sets itself up like this here. So we're using E on 5th string, G on 4th, B and D on 3rd, E and G on 2nd, and then a high B note up on the first guitar string. So that's our layout that's headed more toward the headstock of the guitar. And then the next layout that I have for you, it's going to go a little more to the body of the guitar set up in 7th position, focused again from the E on 5th string, 7th fret. So it goes like this. The setup of this has E and G on the 5th string. There's a B note on 4th string. And then on the 3rd string, we got D and E, the octave. And then we got a G note on the 2nd string at the 8th fret. And then B and D up on the top 1st string there. So those are a couple of nice layouts that you can work with for the minor 7 off of our E root. And the next thing I want to do is cover the Dorian mode off of the E root as well for you. So Dorian mode is a derivative of the D major scale, which means we play from E to E, but we use the notes of D major. That means that it's a little different than the standard E natural minor scale, because E natural minor has one sharp, F sharp. But when we do Dorian mode, because it's based off of really D major, we wind up getting a C sharp as well. So here's a couple of layers. All kind of rolled up into one large, you know, all-encompassing shape. But again, we're going to do it where we set it up, where we have some notes that are flowing more to the headstock, and then we're going to do some more that go toward the body. The setup of this, though, is going to go from E on the 5th string. We have a D in behind that E. And then when we go to the 4th string, we'll have F sharp, G, and A. On the 3rd string, we'll have B, C sharp, and D. And then we'll have E, F sharp, and G on the 2nd string, with just A and B being grabbed on the 1st guitar string. All right, so that's our layout for those tones. And then when we go off of the 7th position and we are headed more to the body of the guitar, we're going to set it up off 7th fret E, going E, F sharp, and G on 5th string. And then we'll have A and B on 4th, and moving over to the 3rd string, C sharp, D, and E coming next. And then on the 2nd string, we'll have F sharp, G, and A, with B, C sharp, and D on the 1st guitar string. So all together. Alright, so those are our Dorian mode layouts. Combine that with your E minor 7 arpeggio and you got a lot of cool things that you can do here. Now, what I want to do next is, with that jam track that we had studied earlier in the first part of the lesson, I'm going to fire that up. And over this jam track, what we're going to do is set up a phrase that I came together with that covers both the arpeggio work and the Dorian mode. So check it out. Thank you. So let's talk about this and, you know, learn what's going on here. We're starting off through an arpeggio, and then we're grabbing into a Dorian tone, the 10th fret 4th string. It's a C natural tone, because at that moment we get a C chord being played right at that spot. Another thing that's going to happen is up on the 2nd string, we're going to move up into 10th fret A, which is the root of the next chord. Another cool thing though that's a great sound here is we're drifting into the C sharp quite heavily at this point on 3rd string, because we got a 6 and a 9 and a 6 there, kind of really hammering home into that C sharp on 3rd string. Then we get a 7th fret A, G, A, so a lot of targeting right to the root of that A major chord. And then what we're going to do next is some more arpeggio work into the E minor. We've got 4th string 5th fret, 5th string 7th, back to that 4th string 5th fret, up to a 4th fret of 3rd string, and then we're going to slide forward from the 5th fret to 8th on the 2nd string, bringing us into the 7th position for a 1st string 7th fret B and 9th fret C sharp. And we're just going to hang on the C sharp for the remainder of that full last measure, because that's a strong chord tone in the world of the last chord, which is an A major chord. So there's some really cool things that happen with this, and a lot of targeting of specific notes using both the arpeggio layout and, of course, you know, what's going on with that sound of, you know, both natural minor and the Dorian mode. We've got E natural minor and E Dorian, because, you know, for instance, when we're playing on the C major chord coming in there, that C major chord, that is more so from the natural minor key of E. But then when we get the A major chord rolling in, that's coming from the Dorian mode. So it's really kind of an interesting blend. And when you have situations like this that move between modes, when you have harmonies, the aspect of learning how to target into those tones specifically can be just amazing, because you're hitting notes that are really on par with everything that's going on at the moment. It takes a little bit of effort and some study and some practice, but once it starts coming together for you, it's incredibly valuable. So I'm going to wrap things up now for this video. I hope to see you next on the Patreon video, where I'm really going to drill into the world of arpeggios with lots of technical examples and some playing examples as well for you. So I hope to see you on the Patreon lesson next. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon supporters, you'll get to watch this lesson's part 2 video, where I'm going to get into an in-depth look at both the technique and the application of arpeggios. And this is going to be really valuable, especially if arpeggios are kind of a mystery to you right now. Plus, along with a bonus video, as a Patreon member, you'll also get a jam track, and you'll get to download a detailed PDF handout. And it is detailed. It covers everything that we do in the YouTube video, and then, of course, everything we're going to be doing in the Patreon video as well. So head down to my Patreon page and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. Well, guys, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. That thumbs up really helps a lot with the YouTube algorithm, and it gets me more views here on YouTube. Also, remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube, so go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again later this week with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.